These are some of the policemen who took to the streets on the 2nd of July 2018 in Maiduguri, the Borno state capital, to protest non-payment of their salaries. This caused quite a stir across the country and within the police force, prompting the vice president to summon the inspector general to an emergency meeting. When the matter is raised in the House of Representatives, members are united in their stance.
The House further notes that the protest, which is said to have been carried out by some men of the Mobile Police Force Unit, popularly known as MOPOL, not only caused severe traffic grid but also affected economic and social activities and brought the city of Maiduguri to a standstill for several hours.
It is actually a thing of shame that the Nigerian police will be reduced to the level whereby his rank and file will openly be protesting just because they need to be paid their entitlement.
To avoid a recurrence, according to the lawmakers, the inspector general should pay the ultimate price.
Police officers with guns are blocking the road.
Silence, please. Honorable members, silence, please.
Calling the IG, based on what I saw, calling the IG a thief.
I also want to remind us here that recently, on two occasions on this floor, not quite a month, we have passed a vote of no confidence on the top echelon of the Nigerian police on this floor. So it means this is a justification for what we have done.
The thing has moved to the uniformed men, that is his own boys or his own men who are working with him. The implication of this is that they no longer have confidence in the ability of their boss.
Further debate on the matter was then brought to a halt as the lawmakers resolved to set up an ad hoc committee to investigate and report back to the House within 2 weeks. This is coming at a time when the country is facing internal security challenges, a time when these very security officials should be focused on providing the needed security for citizens. Terry Ikumi, Channels Television News.